Today on the Certified Q&A, let's tackle another question for the Google Cloud Platform Associate Cloud Engineer. It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this scenario, you have a project using BigQuery. You want to list all BigQuery jobs for that project. You want to set this project as a default for the BQ command line tool. What should you do? A. Use gcloud config set project to set the default project. B. Use BQ config set project to set the default project. C. Use gcloud generate config URL to generate a URL to the Google Cloud Platform console to set the default project. Or D. Use BQ generate config URL to generate a URL to the Google Cloud Platform console to set the default project. So the key part of this question is very simply about setting the default project, and that will be used by the BQ command line tool. Now let's look at each of the options and see which one would be the most appropriate. The way I like to approach this question is to find certain groups. We can see that there are two sets of possibilities. One in and around gcloud, and one using the BigQuery command line tool BQ. The question is there a way in which we can eliminate one of these options? The other group that we have is to set the default project using either gcloud or BQ, or to use generate config URL to generate a URL using either gcloud or BQ. We follow the same approach here. Is there a way we can eliminate any one of these groups and therefore have a reduced set to work with? So my tip for approaching questions like this is that if there are bunches of similar options, we can in one choice eliminate a whole bunch of them, right? So we can eliminate a whole group of them and thus reduce the number of things that we will have to deal with. Let's look at what these tools are. What is BQ? BQ is the command line tool that allows you to do various tasks on BigQuery, like listing tables and data sets, creating new tables and data sets, to edit and delete entries, to export data, to import data, to transfer data sets. Almost everything around BigQuery can be done with BQ when you're trying to access the data within BQ. What is gcloud then? gcloud is the primary tool to access whole of Google Cloud itself. For almost all tasks on Google Cloud, including setting up machines, setting up identity and access management, to enable APIs, gcloud is the tool that you have to use. Now, there are some tools for certain sub-solutions. Famously, some of them are gsutil, which is primarily for cloud storage, BQ for BigQuery, and kubectl, as you might know, is the command line tool to work with Kubernetes. Not with GKE, remember, but with Kubernetes itself. So in the same way that we have this distinction between gcloud and kubectl, gcloud allows you to set up VMs and clusters within GKE, the Google Kubernetes Engine, whereas kubectl is the tool that allows you to make changes to the cluster. In a similar way, BigQuery is a tool that allows you to work with data within BigQuery, whereas gcloud is still the tool to use when you're setting up, say, permissions on BigQuery. So within these two sets of possibilities, when comparing gcloud and BQ, we can see that gcloud is a tool that will allow you to set project defaults. Right? When you're setting project defaults, configuration, all of that is a function of gcloud, whereas BQ, which is the command line tool for BigQuery, is only to access and modify and work with the data within BigQuery. Given this now, we can therefore eliminate BQ as an option for any of these choices. So option B, BQ config set project, that's not where you do it. Right? You can't set the configuration for a project with BQ. You can only access and work with BigQuery data using BQ. Remember that a project is not only about BigQuery. There could be a lot of different things that are used by those projects, right? So when you're setting all of that, it is going to be gcloud that is a tool you use and not BigQuery. So we can also eliminate option D just because it says, you know, it is starting off with BQ, even though we have not seen the remaining option. Now let's look at the second sets of options. So A and B uses some way to set the default project almost directly, right? There is an option as a subcommand within gcloud or BQ, but now we've eliminated BQ, so it must be gcloud. So either you set the default project as a direct command using one of these tools, or you generate a URL which will then direct you to Google Cloud Platform Console, and there you can set the default project. Now, the option C and D to generate a URL and then to configure it on the command line tool, on the Google Cloud Console, seems slightly roundabout for me, right? So I'm not very sure, I wouldn't be very confident about this particular. What this question is trying to confuse you with is the OAuth approach to configuring external apps. So when you're configuring external apps, it takes you to a web browser where you have to log in, and that gives you the OAuth token, which is then used by the application. That is not the approach that Google Cloud uses, because not everything in Google Cloud is going to be done via a browser. You could just do it from a command line tool. You could just use an SSH into the Google Cloud project and configure settings. You don't need to necessarily have a OAuth kind of mechanism. So given that, we can eliminate the generate configure URL option. Again, like I said, it's trying to confuse you with the OAuth approach, which is not what Google Cloud uses to set project defaults or to set project configurations. In fact, there is a direct way to do it from the gcloud command line tool itself. Now, given that we've eliminated these overlapping sets of options, we have eliminated BQ as an option, and we've eliminated config URL as an option. We are left only with the right one, which is option A, which is to use gcloud config set project to set the default project. Now, let us confirm if that is actually the case. Looking at the documentation for BigQuery, you can see that there is a way, for example, in this case, to list the jobs that are part of the BigQuery project. At the bottom, it says that you can specify the project ID if you need to access the jobs within a particular project. But then you can skip it if you set the default project somewhere. And the way to do that would be using gcloud. There is no way to do this directly using BigQuery. Via BigQuery, you can specify the project ID, but if you want to set the default project, that is done using gcloud. Let us confirm that on the command line for gcloud now. So in command one, we have said gcloud config set project, and we've given some non-existing project with no jobs. Then when we list the config properties using gcloud config list and then grep the project, you can see the project is set to some non-existing project. When we do a bqls-j, which should list the jobs, you get an error in the operation because that project doesn't exist. So there is a way to list the jobs. Now the question is, can we set the default project? Now having unset everything, let's now set it and try this example again. We use gcloud config set project, a project that we use. And then when we list the project, you can see that the default project has been set. Now when we do bq-lsj, it is able to automatically pick up the default project and show you the jobs in that project. What are the key learnings we can take away from this question? In the approach to answering these questions, one method I use is to look for common patterns. If I find the same wordings on different questions, I kind of group them together. and I say, what within this will help me eliminate maybe the two of them or the remaining two? Look for both similarities and differences in the options. When they start off in a certain way, usually there'll be one command or subcommand that is slightly different. So look for which parts of the answer option are exactly the same and which parts make a difference. And maybe that's what you need to review and see which applies to this particular question. Based on that, you can eliminate groups of options. And as before, we reduce the chances that we are wrong by just keeping the ones that will be most relevant. In terms of studying, you have to get hands-on experience with the gcloud tool. I highly recommend some of the quick labs. All the basic labs, the fundamental and the beginner labs, take you through using gcloud, and that will be very useful for your learning. In terms of additional study, I would also like you to look at BQ, kubectl, and gsutil, and see what do they serve, what are their capabilities, and what are their limitations. Under what circumstances do you use these tools, and under what circumstances do you use gcloud? I will leave you with a few references. If you're interested in picking up loads more learning on Google Cloud, go ahead and subscribe right away.